Right heading. Tree body diagram. We also write this as FBD. Tree body diagram, also called as FBD. First point, for body, consider body with point mass. So we don't draw entire body, we only take point where its mass will be assumed to be situated. So whenever you are drawing free body diagram, first always think of body's point mass. Then we will show all forces acting on it, not by it, acting on it. Third, we consider force from ground. That means inertial frame. So when you see from the ground on the body, then whatever forces are acting, that we consider. So just write this 3 point, then with example I will explain how we can find. Yes, can I clear this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now see what is meaning of this statement. First example. If this is body of mass M placed on surface, body of mass M placed on surface, I want free body diagram. So forces acting on this body will be, one is its weight mg and normal reaction by the surface N. So for free body diagram, take the center of the mass M, one force is acting downward, that is mg, other force is acting upward, that is N. This is called free body diagram. Any doubt in free body diagram? Nothing we did new, that body ka jagah pe point liya, forces acting diagram mein dikha diya. So N is upward normal reaction by the surface. Dekho, surface bhi dega reaction niche. Ye nahi banane apne. Khali body pe jo act ho raha hai, wo dikhane. Now tell me this, in this what, how we can get this, the inclined plane. We have placed the body. Here is the weight acting downward, mg. Normal reaction acting on the body. Perpendicular to the surface and mass is M. So consider that mass M, force is acting like this, normal reaction, weight mg. Isko bolte free body diagram. Difficult hai?
No sir.
No sir.
Just try it. The next lecture se MCQ thode din ke baad karne lagunga, ek do lecture ke baad ye sab usme aayega. We are doing law of motion chapter. What I have shown is called free body diagram. That means forces acting on the body. If you are done, then tell me.
Done, sir.
So I can clear this diagram. Nija, done?
Yes, sir, done.
Okay, Dia?
Yes, sir.
Did you get a diagram?
Yes.
Take care, the next take care. There is one pulley connected to a support. Pulley is massless, frictionless. मतलब इसका खुद का वजन नहीं है. Massless and frictionless. Tied to the string. At the free end, we are having mass m1 here and another free end mass m2. I want free body diagram for this. So, pehla is pe force kya act hoega? Iska vajan downward, that is m1g, and tension which is always away from that body. Same way here, its weight downward and tension away from the body. So if I draw free body diagram, free body diagram for M1, then this is mass M1, force acting is tension P1 upward and M1G downward. Same way, free body diagram for M2 will be M2, T2 acting upward, M2G acting downward. Now for pulley, we'll see. Free body diagram for pulley. If you consider pulley, then at this point, tension is acting away from it. At this point, tension is acting away from it. Should I call tension T1, T2 or both are same? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Both T1, T2 are same or they are different?
Different, sir.
Different, sir.
No. It is same because same dhaga ja raha hai na aisa.
Haan, sir. Haan, sir.
Okay.
So, naam to maine T1, T2 diya either just to understand properly. But actually, same thread ka T same rehta hai. तो नीचे लिख दूंगा वेर T1 इज T2. Have you followed concept? पूरा इधर तक?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
अभी पुली को देखते हैं. ये पुली का सेंटर पॉइंट है ना? तो पुली का सेंटर ऑफ मास पे आ जाओ. उसका मास तो जीरो है, मतलब नथिंग विल बी एक्टिंग फ्रॉम हियर. बट इसका लेफ्ट साइड पे यू आर हैविंग T1 डाउनवर्ड, दिस इज T2. और ये इसका भी कुछ तो टेंशन रहेगा क्योंकि सपोर्ट है. सो आई एम कॉलिंग दिस एज T3. सो दिस विल बी एक्टिंग T3. दिस इज फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम फॉर पुली. क्लियर? ऑल द थ्री क्लियर?
यस सर.
ओके, ड्रॉ. सो स्लोली आई एम गिविंग. ये सब प्रॉब्लम में अप्लाई करना है. हेलो. हाँ, EMI का ये इसका 12th का उसका आंसर का ठीक है, चलेगा. आंसर भेजा, चेक करता हूँ. मतलब आपने 11th का भेज दिया, 12th का भेज दिया ना, और कौन सा? तीन पेपर बोला है ना, और प्रथम का भेजा. बराबर. हाँ, और प्रथम का भेजा ना. अरे यार, इतना बात किया आपने तो बोला प्रथम का कल टेस्ट है, तो मैंने बोला ठीक है. मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट और मैग्नेटिज्म से 100 में से 25 सम. हाँ ठीक है. ठीक है, ये मैं क्या MCQ नहीं है, थियरी है. If you complete, tell me fast.
Completed.
Okay. Everybody has completed. Can I clear it out?
Yes, sir.
Fine, thank you. Now, based on this basic knowledge, we have to find tension in the string at equilibrium position. See, whenever word equilibrium comes, matlab net force is zero. Or what's the problem? Newton's first law. So first question heading is, find tension in both the strings. I'm showing the diagram for system shown. This is a body of mass 2 kg. This is another body of mass 5 kg. We want what is tension in both the string. So I can draw free body diagram for two bodies. And then looking at the forces at equilibrium, they should be zero. We can conclude. So pehle ye body dekhte hain. Ye body का टेंशन ऐसा है ना ऊपर है ना.
यस सर.
यस सर.
सो इफ आई कॉल दिस एज T1, इधर से टेंशन ऐसा नीचे आएगा ना इसका. इज इट T1 और T2?
T2.
T2, वेरी गुड. धागा अलग है इससे, T2. और इसका खुद का वजन भी एक्ट होएगा ना ऐसा नीचे.
हां सर.
दैट इज 2 × G. सो इफ आई टेक फ्री body diagram for 2 kg, then 2 ka vajan, 2 × G, that is mg is acting downward, tension T2 is acting downward, tension T1 is acting upward, and for 5 kg its weight is acting downward, that is 5g, and tension is away from the body. So this is T2 acting upward. So can I say T2 must be 5g? Because they are in equilibrium, so they should cancel each other. So 5 × G is 10, 50 newton is the tension in the lower part. Any doubt in this answer?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Now, for first diagram, from first, T1 is upward, should be balanced by T2 plus 2G, because equilibrium means upward, downward should balance each other. So, T2 I got as 50, and 2G means 2 × 10. That will become T1 equals to 70 newton. So logically dekha to ye 10 kg ko 5 plus 2 7 7 kg ko ye dhage ne samal ke rakha hai, isliye 70 aa gaya. And free body diagram se bhi same answer aaya. Once again, for first one, its mass is acting downward, tension T2 is away from the mass, T1 is away from the mass. Ek ka away upar, dusre ka away niche. So for first and second, say I got T1 and T2, 50 and 70 newton. Solve now. First we are doing numerical based sum, then MCQ will start.
Done, sir.
Okay, let others also come through.
Yes.
Done? Yeah, Nija, done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next question. a string is making 37 degree with vertical tied to a block of mass 5 kg. This is the port. I want tension in strings. See, whenever you see 37 degree and 53 degrees, you should remember one right angle triangle. This is 37 degree. So 37 and 53 will have triplet of Pythagoras, 3, 4, 5. ये रहने वाला है. तो कौन सा 3, कौन सा 4, कौन सा 5? 5 तो guarantedly यही रहने वाला है, hypotenuse. 37, 53 से छोटा है. तो साइड ऑपोजिट टू स्मॉलर एंगल इज ऑलवेज स्मॉलर. तो इसको 3, इसको 4. सेम वे इफ इट इज दिस, इफ आई टेक 53 डिग्री, सो दिस इज 5, दिस शुड बी 4, दिस शुड बी 3, बिकॉज 53 इज ग्रेटर देन 37. फ्रीक्वेंटली क्वेश्चन विल कम इन JEE. सो वेन एवर इट इज 53 एंड 37, थिंक ऑफ राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. 37 इज स्मॉलेस्ट साइड, उसके सामने 3, फिर हाइपोटन इज 5, दूसरा 4 एंड सो ऑन. नाउ यू ऑल कैन लुक द डायग्राम केयरफुली. आई वॉन्ट टू ड्रॉ फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम. सो दिस इज दैट मास का सेंटर. एक तो उसका वेट एक्ट होगा ना नीचे.
यस सर.
हाउ मच एम इन टू जी, दैट मीन्स 5 g. Then this tension is away. I'm calling this as T1. This tension is away. I'm calling it T2. Anybody who has not followed this trick?
Understood, sir.
Followed, sir.
Now, all the three quantities are not in horizontal vertical. So we have to resolve. That means if I resolve this 37 wala case, so yes, component T2 ka component. This is 37. So common sense says this is also 37 because alternate angles are congruent. And this is another one. So this will be T2 cos 37, T2 sine 37. Theta ka baju wala is always cos, other one is sine. Now at equilibrium, all horizontal vertical will cancel each other. So T2 ko resolve kiya, matlab ye T2 abhi absent hai. Ye components are acting. So can I say T1 must be T2 sine 37?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So T1 is T2. What is sine 37? Opposite side upon hypotenuse. So can I say 3 by 5? We can, na? 3 by 5?
Yes, sir.
Iske aage I cannot solve because neither I know T1 nor I know T2. Now for second diagram, second case. Also, this were horizontal. Abhi vertical I will check. इधर लिख दो फॉर हॉरिजॉन्टल फोर्सेस एट इक्विलिब्रियम दे आर बैलेंसिंग फॉर वर्टिकल लेट अस चेक अपवर्ड इज T2 कॉस 37 दैट इज इक्वल टू डाउनवर्ड विच इज 5 g. What is cos 37? Can anybody say cos 37?
4 by 5.
Very good. One second. Hello? Yeah. Uh-huh. Correct, 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 correct. Yeah. She is in 12th right now.
ओके नो प्रॉब्लम नो प्रॉब्लम वी कैन स्टार्ट It will be for entire 12 50,000 Indian rupees. Yeah. Huh. Okay. Acha.
No, I will I will not keep fixed timetable. So can you are at home or you are in the office right now, madam? So if I call at around 3:30 or 4 and discuss with the student also, what are her availabilities? Then I will frame the timetable and give you. No problem. You can. Yeah. No problem. Yes. Thank you. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Sorry, yeah. 37 will be 4 by 5, and 5G is 50. That means if we cross multiply, we'll get 250 upon 4 as T2.
Yes, sir.
T2, I got 250 upon 4. How to get T1? Substitute in first one. Is it? Not following?
Yes, sir, understood.
So can I say from first one, T1 will be T2, which I got 250 upon 4 into that 3 by 5, that is equals to 50. So 150 upon 4 is T1 and 250 upon 4 is T2. Which you have to divide further. I have left like this because I am understanding a concept. Have you followed? Or again you want explanation?
Understood, sir.
Ye 3-4-5 triangle ka samajh gaya?
Yes, sir.
Whenever it is 37 or 53, always think of this triangle because many places state will be given this value. And when they give this, then they don't give you tan, sine, cos. Aapko triangle yaad rakhna hai. Abhi 37 chota angle hai. तो उसके सामने वाला साइड विल बी 3 57 37 से 53 इज ग्रेटर देन 37 सो साइड ऑपोजिट टू दैट इज 4 एंड वी नो हाइपोटेन्यूज इज द लॉन्गेस्ट साइड सो एज पर दैट दैट विल बी 5 ओके
यस सर
ध्रुव
यस सर
एनी डाउट
नो सर
ओके प्लीज कॉपी फुल सॉल्यूशन Diagram draw, then this free body diagram which I have drawn, that you draw, then for horizontal equate force, for vertical equate force, very simple. Do you have any doubt?
No, sir.
Any doubt, please ask us. See, physics, if your doubts are clear, physics becomes easier.
Done, sir.
Okay. Everybody is done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nija?
Yes, sir.
See you next. This is the diagram given. Question is again same. Find tension in string. Now see, this chapter is actually, even vectors also is involved in that. That's why vectors, I told, it should be very much perfect. So this is one support. Here there is one body of mass root 2 kg. It is connected to two strings like this. Two strings making angle 30 degree and 60 degree. We want tension in the string. Are they same string or different string first? Are they same string or different string?
So they are different. They are different strings.
So tension don't call T1, it will be T1, T2.
Yes, sir.
So if I call this as T1, so this will be T2 and iska vajan niche root 2G. Now I'm drawing with this free body diagram. This is center of mass acting downward root 2G. And this is that T1 making 60 degree with horizontal. This is T2 making 30 degree with horizontal. Amay, can you tell me what will be horizontal component of T1? Cos or sine?
Sorry, horizontal component?
Of T1?
Horizontal component will be sine.
No, beta. देखो ऐसा है ना, इसका horizontal component.
Okay, sorry.
T1 cos of 60. And this will be T1 sine of 60. Clear? Anmol?
Anmol? Yes, sir.
Now you tell me T2 wala component. What will be horizontal wala? T2 ka?
T2 sine 30.
Why you are making mistake?
Sir, cos 30. Sorry, sir.
Theta ke baju wala cos. Don't make that mistake. No.
Yes, sir.
T2 cos of 60. Now again at equilibrium, horizontal forces are same as vertical forces. So first I am taking for horizontal. T1 cos 60 must be T2 cos 30. Left and right are balancing at equilibrium. What is cos 60? Half. What is cos 30? Root 3 by 2. Therefore, T1 becomes root 3 times T2. I got relation between T1 and T2. Now, for vertical forces, we'll see equilibrium. For vertical forces, upward force is T1 sine 60, T1 sine 60, T1 sine 60, plus T2 cos 60, correct?
Yes, sir.
And downward is only root 2g. What is T1 value?
Root 3 times T2.
Correct. So T1 I can write root 3 times T2. Cos 60 is how much? Sine 60, sorry.
T1 cos
60. This is T2 cos 30. And either T2, मैंने mistake कर दिया. T2 sine 30. T2 sine 30. So this is T2 sine 30. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. plus t2. What is sine 30?
1 upon 2.
Correct. And root 2g, I can write root 2 into 10. Please copy this much. So shall I explain again, or everybody has followed the concept of the forces? फिर से देख लो, ये root 2g, this is t1, we can resolve into two component, theta का बाजू वाला t1 cos, the upper one t1 sin. Similarly, this is t2, making angle 30, so horizontal is t2 cos 30 and vertical is t2 sin 30. And then you have to just compare horizontal and vertical forces. Dhruv, Mayank, Anmol, Amay, everybody is followed perfectly.
Yes.
Okay, Nija and Dia. This is basic sums. Then slowly we'll come to difficulty level. First diagram I can clear? First one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, just look on the board now, then you complete. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. T2 upon 2 plus T2 upon 2 equals to root 2 into 10. Now this will become 3 plus 1. 4 T2 upon 2 is 10 root 2. 2 into 2. Therefore T2 equals to
5 root 2.
Yes, we got T2 5 root 2. What will be T1? Root 3 into 5 into root 2?
Yes, sir.
That means what will be T1 then further? Oh, yeah, 5
times root 2 root 3. Root
6. Bas, khatam. Kitna simple hai.
Done, sir.
Yes, coming back. I can clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, for others also, is it done?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Next question. Find tension. See, please. Understand full concept so that in MCQ it will be just a cakewalk. Find tension in string and normal reaction. Find tension in string and normal reaction on mass M in equilibrium. Mass M.
Hello? Hello? Yeah? Madam, madam, call me after 4 o'clock. I'm not interested. This time body is in contact while I appear showing. Having mass M tied to a support. Dhaga bhi hai. String also we have and normal reaction will also come because of this surface in contact. Chalo. I want direction of tension. Up or down? Direction of tension, up or down?
To the right, no?
Right side. Right side is upward only, no? Now, I'm not telling vertically upward. Yes. This way, right? Correct? This is correct, actual? Actual correct?
Mm.
Yes. And weight is downward, no? Vertically?
Yes.
And normal reaction is perpendicular to the surface. So these are three forces. Can you identify all the three properly now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Ab iska free body diagram bana do. See, if this is mg, if this angle is theta, to ye bhi theta hota hai na? Dekho, ye aisa surface hai. ये नॉर्मल है देन एंगल इज 90. मैं ये सरफेस को ऐसा थोड़ा सा टेढ़ा कर दू तो ये वाला भी उतनी टेढ़ा होएगा ना. तो नॉर्मल उतने से ही टेढ़ा होगा ना ये नीचे वाला लाइन. तो ये भी थीटा. इतना समझ गए?
यस.
सो mg cos थीटा होगा ना ये थीटा के बाजू वाला mg cos ना.
हां सर.
एंड दिस विल बी mg sin थीटा. आई hope everybody has followed. So actually what I did, I tried to resolve along the parallel to the surface and perpendicular to the surface. Clear? Or again you want explanation? This is the surface, weight is acting downward, normal reaction, tension, mg is resolved into two part, theta ka baju wala mg cos, other one mg sin. This is n, this is p. Clear?
Yes sir.
Okay. Yes sir.
Okay. If these doubts keep on clearing, because in mcq then again you ask, you will take time. Chalo abhi main iska free body diagram baju mein bana leta hu. What are forces acting? This is the body. Here we have mg का component, इसका जरूरत नहीं है because component बना दिया. mg cos theta, this is n, this is p, this is mg sin theta. At equilibrium all forces should balance. Same line वाला force ऊपर नीचे balance, right left balance. So can we say normal reaction is balancing mg cos?
Yes sir.
And tension is balancing mg sin. To ho gaya na, normal bhi aa gaya, tension bhi aa gaya. Normal is mg cos, tension is mg sin. Not followed? Sab kuch kya baith gaya lagta hai, nahi samjha?
Followed sir, followed.
Acha, please copy that.
Done, sir.
Yes, everybody has completed with this diagram?
Yes, sir.
Next one. Again, inclined plane, inclined at angle theta. Suppose theta is 37 degrees. And here we are having a block of mass 5 kg. This is made to pass over only and carries one more mass, 3 kg here. Mass of 3 kg. I am interested in if system is in equilibrium, find theta, tension and normal reaction. Same thread hai, toh tension same hoega. First you draw only this diagram, then I'm drawing the forces acting. Completed, na?
Yes, sir.
अब ये clear दिख रहा है, ये body का वजन 3g downward, tension T ऊपर. तो free body separate नहीं बना है, तो भी दिख रहा है ना मुझे clear cut कि T must balance 3g.
Yes, sir.
What is g? I will take 10. So I got tension as 30 newton. First part is over. Now coming to this body. Same wire, so same tension T, but away from the body. Normal reaction perpendicular to the surface. And weight of the body 5g downward. Any doubt in these three forces?
No, sir.
No, sir.
5g I can resolve into two components. 5g I can resolve into two components. 5g cos, because this is theta, cos theta, this will be 5g sine. So 5g sine theta equals to T, and 5g sine theta equals to T. 5g cos theta equals to normal reaction. 5g sin theta is T and 5g cos theta is normal reaction. Suppose this is equation 2 and this was first. So 5g means 5 into 10 into sin theta, T we got 30. So this will get cancelled. Therefore, sine theta equals to 3 upon 5. So this becomes our that right angle triangle. Side opposite to 37 degrees 3. This is 5, this is 4. So can I say theta is 37 from that knowledge?
Yes, sir.
Now only one part left out. Normal reaction. 5g into cos theta. Cos theta is 4 by 5 equals to normal reaction. So therefore 10 into 4 is normal reaction. N equals to 40. So we got tension 30, normal reaction 40, angle theta is 37. Clear? If followed, then please copy till end.
Done, sir.
Okay. Completed.
Okay.
Done, sir.
What is Newton's second law of motion? Rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the force applied and takes place in the direction of force. Correct, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Now, if they ask, show that F equal to ma. Show that F equal to ma. See, F is not always ma. This also keep in mind. F is always rate of change of momentum. Because every time, if mass is not constant, I can't write ma. I will explain how. So I know by Newton's second law of motion, rate of change of momentum equal to force. Correct?
Yes.
This is basic Newton's second law. And from this, we'll have to derive m. So I can say F is final momentum minus initial momentum upon time. Clear? Clear?
Yes.
So consider body of mass m moving with initial velocity u. Let v be the final velocity in time t. Therefore, final momentum is mv, initial momentum is mu upon time t. So m I can take common, v minus u upon t. What is v minus u upon t? Acceleration?
Yes.
So v minus u upon t is acceleration. Therefore, we can say f equal to ma. Now, see, if m is not constant, then I have to write m1, m2. So if mass is constant, then only I can take m common and write m common v minus u as t. So always remember, if they say mass is changing, then don't start with F is ma. You will start with change in momentum upon time. In entrance, they will confuse you like this. 90% mass is constant, but 5% it may not be constant. Like rocket ke andar, fuel jab bahar nikalta hai na, ye pure system ka mass kam hone lagta hai. So there I can't use ma. Then what to use, I will explain you just now. Copy this much? In 11th college exam, they can ask, show that F equal to ma. Show that
answer
F equal to ma and tak prove karo by Newton's second law of motion. Rate of change of momentum equal to force.
Done, sir.
Okay. Everybody has done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good.
Yes, sir.
I'm clearing. Abhi ek chota sa derivation, then we can stop. in today's lecture. Differential form of Newton's second law. Differential form of Newton's second law. We know F is rate of change of momentum. If change is very small, this delta we can write dp and delta t we can write dp. Maths mein isko derivative or differential bolte. What is p? Mass into velocity, which is called momentum. Now, if you remember, I have explained you derivative of product. Agar yaad hai to. It is m
derivative. Yes, sir.
Yaad hai na? Haan, theek hai. So v into dm by dt. That means this is general formula of force now. Now we all can say if mass is constant तो उसका डेरिवेटिव क्या होएगा बोलो
अनमोल जीरो
वेरी गुड जीरो सो कैन आई से देयरफॉर एम विल बिकम एम डीवी बाय डीटी प्लस वी इनटू जीरो नॉट डीवी बाय डीटी इज ए तो वही मिला ना एफ इज एम में व्हेन मास इज कांस्टेंट क्लियर हेलो
यस सर
कॉन्सेप्ट समझ गया आपको बराबर
हाँ सर
डन सर
नेक्स्ट टाइम ऑनवर्ड्स आई विल टेक क्लास टिल 3:45 टुडे मॉर्निंग आई वाज नॉट वेल सो आई कुड नॉट टेक लेक्चर ओवर देयर इससे मैं आपको इतना स्टॉप करता हूँ नेक्स्ट अवर लेक्चर एज यूजुअल मंडे वेनेसडे फ्राइडे टुमारो सैटरडे वी हैव गॉट एक्स्ट्रा क्लास अवर यूजुअल टाइम 9:30 to 10:30 क्लियर
यस सर
कुछ कंफ्यूजन मत रखो फिक्स टाइम है सर एक्स्ट्रा वाला ट्यूजडे थर्सडे सैटरडे and regular Monday, Wednesday, Friday as usual time. Sunday test is on, measurement chapter only theory type and MCQ 1 to 100 may say any 25.
Okay, sir.
So best of luck, write paper well. Even if it goes worse, don't be worried. You have to rectify your mistake. Mistakes rectify yes, hota hai, automatically mark padta hai. Aur physics mein wapas bolta hu, doubt hai to clear kar lena. Physics kuch nahi hai, it is clearance of doubt. जिसने भी
yes,
क्लियर किया और टीचर्स ने समझाया आपको समझ गया तो आप एकदम बेस्ट करोगे सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे नेक्स्ट वी विल मीट फॉर एक्स्ट्रा क्लास सैटरडे इवनिंग रेगुलर क्लास अगेन मंडे ओके
ओके सर
दैट्स ऑल फॉर